Okay, all right, we are live. Okay, just gotta get set up a bit here, just so I, I wanna pull up the chat just in case anybody, I don't think anybody's gonna join for this, but just in case, I just wanna look, you know? So, we'll load that up real quick, make sure I'm in the chat. Okay. All right. Welcome. Hello, everybody. My name is Cameron Utz, and welcome to my first ever live stream. That's great. Okay. So this is a live stream for my video games, culture, and society class being taught here at SOU. And this is for my midterm project, actually. This is going to, basically, what I'm going to be doing here is I'm going to be playing the game for a little while, and then I'm just going to be explaining the history, you know, that bit of background on the game, how I'm going to, like, talk you through how I'm playing it. This is a really good game. So it's Chris Sawyer's Locomotion. And I highly doubt that anybody who is watching this or will be watching this later knows what the hell this game is. Also, I gotta put a cap on the profanity. This is for class, after all. Anyway, I doubt that many of you know what this game is, but if you've heard of Transport Tycoon, this is literally the exact same as that game. And I'm going to talk about it as soon as I get into the game. Let's stop looking at the title screen menu and just get into it. So it gives you a bunch of pre-made maps and scenarios. Basically, I guess I should explain that in this game, you run a transportation company. You can build trains, trams, buses. You're given this big map. You got to build all these transportation things to carry passengers and then other goods like chemicals, paper, logs, farm stuff. Just stuff like that. It's a very bare bones simulation game. Why am I moving this? And that's pretty much all it is. So I took the liberty of making a custom-made map earlier today for the purposes of this class. Even though there's a bunch of different maps to choose from, I'm just going to choose this one because it's just sort of a control variable. And also, I didn't realize how small the island turned out to be, but hey, let's do it. Oh, this music is just grand. Okay, so the very first thing you do in this game is you got to name your owner. This is basically who you are. So I'm going to name myself Cameron Utz at SOU. I don't know. EDU. Nah, I won't go that boring. I'm just gonna go with Cam, just for the Cameron Utz. This is official. I'm a business owner. And then you can choose from a bunch of funny faces here. Haha. Also, oh yeah, my webcam is probably blocking this whole area. All you're missing is just the load and save area, like the save button and like music options and stuff like that. Is not important. You're not missing anything important up here. But anyway, I'm gonna choose a nice face to represent me in this game. This is the CEO of the company. Let's go with this guy. He looks friendly. Alright, and then the next thing you do is you want to build your headquarters for your company, because you're running a transport company. You need headquarters to get started. Oh yeah, these are going to pop up through the whole time, anytime there's like a big development in the world. Which is probably going to be... Okay, good. Sometimes when I don't put enough industries in a custom map, then it just doesn't really... it just keeps on, like, generating new industries, so it matches up the number. Anyway, we'll get into that later. I'm going to put my headquarters here in Gogglewood. Yeah, right here is fine. And this is gonna just slowly construct into a nice little building. And with that, our company is up and running. So, now what I have to do is find something to transport. And there's a lot of different options here. So basically, You know, you can run your whole business just like transporting people from like town to town, but it's not gonna get you a lot of money. And the point of this game is to make a lot of money. And you gotta have the best services and stuff. Wow. You gotta have the best transit network, you know, making the most money, transporting the most things, you know, being efficient, timely. And eventually, some other companies are gonna show up for competition. And they're gonna make things all the worse. And so I gotta stay on top, and or at least like in the top three. There's gonna be like seven other people. Anyway, enough talk about that. Let me find something to transport. I should also mention that this is my first time live streaming anything, so I'm kind of getting used to it, talking about stuff while playing a video game. God. Oh, man. Oh, they're not giving me a whole lot to work with. Oh, okay, here we go. Yeah, so we got some coal mines here, and we got a coal-powered power plant over here. Or what is it called? It's the power station. So it requires coal. This one does not generate anything. Most industries generate something when they're given material to work with, but just to start with, we're just going to transport some coal to this power supply. That it doesn't benefit us anything aside from just making us money from this one transit. And I am going to make a train from here to there, because this is the perfect distance. It's a bit too long for trucks, but it's just long enough for a good rail line. Let's actually focus up. So, I think this would be efficient. Well, let me check chat real quick. See if anyone's, okay, good, nothing. All right, not missing anything. So, this way. So, yep, I'm making my, okay. So, I'm gonna hide scenery in buildings, and notice that there's an incline here. I'm going to build my train track so that it is going upwards. Make a little ramp here, and I can curve with that as well. Alright, that's good. And there we go, there's the train tracks. Gonna make a little station on both sides. Both sides need a station, just because, you know, that's obvious. That's where all the goods and stuff are waiting to be picked up. And now that we've got the railroad and the stations, now we can put a train. Yeah, choo choo, let's go. My guy looks really sad. Oh, okay, people are showing up. I see. That did not take long. Anyway, so I'm going to, this particular game mode is set in 1940. First of all, it's why there's swing music in the background. I quite like it myself. And the kind of vehicles that you can buy is limited to the year. So notice how you got all of these old ass trucks. Oh my gosh, I gotta stop swearing. all of these old trucks, that they're from the 1900s, and these are the more recent ones, but even then these are from 1930, so they're not very efficient, but it's the best we got. And you know, there's inflation is a factor as well. I'm gonna go with the Pacific because I have the money to afford it right now, and it's the best train that's available at the moment. And this one is so bad in comparison. This one was designed in 1935, the other one 1910. It doesn't have nearly as much horsepower or anything like that. Okay, so Okay, so we're going to want to buy this, the hopper wagon. It has more capacity than this wagon, and as we can see, it can carry coal and then also iron ore, but we just need the coal. So I'm going to buy, like, just a few of those. Maybe a couple more. And there we go. So what I'm going to do, this isn't necessary, but I'm going to design my route, and it's going to be a full load of coal, and then it's waiting for a full load of coal, and then I'm going to unload all the coal. That way I'm getting maximum money. It helps. The more that you pick up from the station consecutively, the more that the industry produces. So that's just a good way to help maintain things. But yeah, see here, got my train going. Choo-choo. Am I actually going? Hold on, I'm going to pause for just a second. Pause the game. Because I should be streaming right now. Oh, yeah, we're good. Hey, Logan, what's up? Ayo. Hey, good to see you. Thanks for coming along. It looks like everything is running just fine. Hope that this is some good background noise for you. And let's go. All right, so the train is going through the forest. You can't see it. But, yep, and now it's arriving at the power plant station. And look at that, new land speed record, 29 miles per hour. That doesn't really do anything for me, but it's just a cool thing. First coal delivery to Teddy Wood. Yeah. But yeah, I just made $9,000 off of that one run. Which is not a whole lot compared to how much I could be having. But, you know, we'll get there. So what I can do is I can speed up. Wow, this makes money. Because you don't want to spend too fast in this game. You don't want to set up too many lines of service at the same time, or else you're just going to be spending all your money on just a bunch of different vehicles, and then you'll be in debt, and then you'll be pulling loans. So here's an important thing. I forgot to change my transport name. I don't want to be Cameron. Oh, it's transport. We'll do that in a second. But anyway, this is the money window. And what you can do is you can take a loan out. I set the maximum to like 300,000 or something. But you know, the bigger the loan, the more that you have to pay interest every month. And that adds up. If you take too much money, you're going to be owing so much in enough time. So it's no fun. But yeah, there's my train going, and I think I'm going to look for something else to do. Okay, looks like I'm on top right now. Oh, let me change my company name. Yeah, so I've got the highest company value right now. My approval ratings are up. And these other two don't seem to... Rumblewick Transport and Cocklehead Carts. How silly. When I was designing this mode, I set the town names to be silly style town names, so all of these towns, this entire map is pretty much randomly generated, including the towns and the names of the towns. Okay, what are we gonna call? Let's call our transport SOU Express, just because it's college, and you know, I gotta remember that this is a stream for class. And while I'm at it, oh no, somebody already took red. Oh, that other guy quit. Wait, really? These are CPU players. I did not know you could do that. Oh, the other guy took red though. Okay. Well, I'm also gonna be red. And white? What's the other school color? I'm gonna go black. Red and black. Raider Express. There we go. Now I'm a true alumni. Alright, so looks like our train is doing pretty well. Yeah, it's making a monthly profit of about $6,000, so we're good. Let's make another another train. Hey, look at that, I'm already at engineer level. The other person quit. What happened? Oh, there's another guy. Trottingbury Hollage. So performance index, it's like the percentage of how well you're doing. Like if you got a lot of debt, it's gonna go down. If you're not doing a lot, making a lot of plays, it's gonna go down. But I seem to be doing pretty well right now. When there's 10 stages that you can go on, so there's engineer, there's transport coordinator. It's basically different levels of just a job. Like the first one is plate layer, as you can see this man is on. But that's pretty much the... Okay, not quite the game. I'm just gonna do something simple, close to my HQ, no less. And I am going to set up a bus route between these two towns. And check this out, I can totally destroy this house right here. And I suffer no consequences. That's capitalism, baby! Alright, I'm gonna put one passenger stop here, and another one right here. That way it's transporting between the two towns, and that'll be a new record, and I think it raises my performance index, actually. Ripoff Haulage. This guy's name is Ricky Ripoff. What a guy. You know what? Now that that other person dropped out, I can change the color to what I wanted. Yeah, bright red, let's go! Alright, I bought a bus. I just went with the nicest bus we got. And for stuff like this, it's actually better to buy multiple buses. But this one, you have to set out a route, so I'm just gonna do this. Route through. Stop at Gogglewood, and stop at Quack Bottom. And that bus is a go. I'm gonna do the same thing for this bus, which is a pretty tedious process, but so be it. And I'm gonna buy another one as well. So this isn't a particularly lucrative business, the transportation of passengers. They're honestly one of the lowest the lowest money-making cargo that you can haul. cargo, people. But, you know, it's just worth having. And also, we'll get to that later. That's pretty much what this game is. Like, I'll show a couple more things. If you've ever played Transport Tycoon, this is literally the exact same game. So, let's get into the background here. So, this game was made by... This is an indie game. From 2004 by a Scottish guy named Chris Sawyer, who is an absolute legend. So basically, he was also responsible for both the original roller. Jumping ahead of myself. He was the one who made the original Transport Tycoon, which really makes me wonder why he made a spiritual successor to his own franchise. But you know, so be it. Also, I'm making a train line. I'm gonna be taking livestock to this food processing plant here, all the way from this livestock farm just down the way. Sorry, vegans. Chris Sawyer, just one Scotsman, he did this entire game. Like, some other guys worked on the graphics and the music a little bit, but he really did most of the stuff. And he also made the original Transport Tycoon series, which is what this is based off of, and he also did the Roller Coaster Tycoon series, which I also could have played. I could have played Roller Coaster Tycoon 2, but I don't have it installed, and I think I can talk about this game a little bit more, just because I think I've played it more. The graphics are pretty much the exact same as Roller Coaster Tycoon 2. Anyway. Oh, I don't have enough money. Okay. I'm gonna take out a little loan. Maybe that wasn't so itty bitty. Let's do that. Okay, so anyway, This game wasn't super well received at release because, again, it's just a... It's pretty much a remake of, like, a game series that he already did. And mind you, this game came out in 2004. And it looks like it's from, like, 1996. Like, it's a pretty... it's a really dated game. Like, the way that it's set up. I have the resolution on as, like... Oh, gosh, what is it? New transport company. Ripoff haulage starts construction near Fiddle Bottom. Okay. The current resolution is 1152 by 864. That's really low. And that's... What's going on here? I guess I forgot to let it go. No, but I really love this game. It's, but the cool thing is that one guy programmed this entire game in the early 2000s using, like, a basis that he already had. And if you've ever seen Roller Coaster Tycoon 2, you'll know that in that game, a bunch of little, like, characters are walking around at the exact same time, doing completely different things. They have their own tasks, their own thoughts, their own agendas. They want to do the, like, a bunch of different things, and there's thousands of them filling up this amusement park. Meanwhile, roller coasters are going, other rides are going, rides break down, you got employees, you got weather to keep up with. There's so many things that he can program into this, and the game just doesn't lag at all. And it's the same thing with this game. It doesn't seem like very much right now, but by the time we get to later in the game, there's going to be so much going on. Like, there's going to be, like, so many trains going back and forth, so many buses, you know, the cities are going to keep getting bigger. Oh yeah, and there's boats. I haven't even gotten into the boats. Oh my god, and the airplanes. Oh, the airplanes. Oh, the airplanes are going to be so, they're going to be all over the place. Anyway, so it's just amazing to me that one dude made this whole shebang. This whole game was just made by one really smart Scottish guy named Chris Sawyer. I don't know if he's still making games today. He's 55. I looked it up. I don't know. But yeah, this is, okay, let me think, where else can I go? I'm kind of just wandering around aimlessly. Let's see, there's a chemical factory there. Oh, is there a forest nearby? I know what I can do. Yeah. I wonder if... No, it wouldn't. Okay, so when I'm making a station, you gotta make sure that it's positioned right. So this station, it doesn't really produce anything because I don't need it to, but it accepts grains and cattle and stuff like that because of the food processing plant. If I put the station in the wrong spot, it's not going to accept what I want it to accept. So, like, if I put a ship station right here, it's not gonna accept grain or livestock for the food processing plant. So I can't build a ship from here to there unless I want to dig some water out. I wonder if there's a steel mill nearby. Oh, man. Wow, I should have set this up a bit better so I... does this take lumber? Yeah, let's go. Okay. Oh, dude. Yeah, let's do it. And I'm actually gonna, just for fun, I'm gonna make a truck line. But yeah, I guess I should talk a bit about my background with the game. Like, why do I love this game so much? And really, it's just because it's a childhood favorite. I remember one day in the back of my car, I was a young boy of, I think, 6 years old, and I was talking to my dad, who is a video, he likes video games, and he and I was talking about, because I loved SimCity as a kid, and I just loved cities and stuff like that, and I also loved trucks, and I was just talking about, you know, they should really make a sim town, or sim truck driving. I want to have a game where I can, I want them to make a game where I can just live, like, make a town and just, you know, I don't have to make a big old city. I don't know what I was talking about, but, my dad, from the driver's seat, he stops me and he says, "What you need to play is this," and he gives me a copy of this game. I don't know where he got it from. I don't know how he had it in his car. Maybe he bought it at, like, a thrift store right beforehand, but he just had it, and he just gave it to me, I definitely didn't get it as a six-year-old, and I was actually really scared of the pop-up stuff, the newspapers, that spooked me. Oh, I'm going down. Oh, I'm still on top, baby. But I just really love this game. I know nobody has ever heard of it. Oh, I gotta be careful. Okay, so here's the thing. So these trucks, they could... So this place is generating paper. So, like, you can see here, this truck just picked up some paper because it can pick up both paper and lumber. So that's a problem, and I forget how to fix it. I think what I'm just gonna do is, Giveaway Central, unload all paper, and unload all lumber. Yeah, unload all lumber, unload all paper. I think that should keep it from, picking up the paper. Oh, wait, they don't even accept paper, do they? What am I supposed to do? Huh? Can I afford to buy an industry yet? No, and even if I wanted to, there's the industry that I want isn't there. There's like a printing factory industry. I don't know if it's in here anywhere. Yeah, I don't see any. Or I'm just missing them. Oh, there's one. That's so far. Oh, that's pretty far away. All the way over here. But yeah, these places take that. That's what the paper's for. Okay, I need to... Oh, okay. So that seemed to work. Okay, that way they shouldn't be picking up paper, or at least if they do, they're not gonna have it to come back. So, lumber. I know that this is a pretty tedious thing, and this is probably pretty boring to watch. Yeah. And also, I don't know how long I'm supposed to be streaming for. I just sort of assumed that, I needed to stream for like an hour or so, because that's how long it usually takes. Okay, looks like it didn't take. Okay, but yeah, looks like the trucks aren't picking up the paper anymore, so that's good. But yeah, there's all these little things that you gotta think about with this game. And that's kind of what I enjoy about it. Chris Sawyer, the mad lad, he really thought of everything. When making this game. Like, there's so many things that you got to think about when running this business. Also, is there any more music? This is the only song available right now? Oh. I might want to speed things up so I can get some better music. Because I know you don't want to be listening to this song anymore. How many people are in right now? Has Logan said anything else? I feel bad if I haven't been responding, but I just don't have a good way to check chat. I don't do this very often. Oh, some Russian dude showed up for a second. That's nice. Okay, so it looks like I've been streaming. Okay, no. I started streaming at 7, so I've been streaming for about half an hour. Okay, I think I'll probably be good at about an hour. Or at least I'm going to play for an hour, or at least when I get there, I'm going to just speed things up so I can reach my goal. So every single scenario in like game mode has a goal to it. And this one, I set it to a pretty simple thing, which was earn a company value of 2 million in a certain amount of years. I'm 31% towards completing the challenge, so that's nice. Topsy line starts to instructions. Okay. I'm still number one. We are number one. Okay, how? Oh, that first train is doing really good. It's making me a lot of money. Yeah, see, look at the difference between the trains and the buses. So the buses are making me a monthly profit of like 32 bucks, 66 bucks, 12 bucks. Meanwhile, the trains are making bank. And the trucks do slightly better, but there's a lot of them. So it's like, combine all of these, and that's the amount I'd be making with one train for this particular juncture. But, you know, trucks are, you know, less expensive, generally. Okay, enough talking, I'm gonna... I can make a train between these two, why not? Let's do it. Yeah! I'm hoping that pretty soon some of the other this song. I'm fast forwarding. I don't know if it's that can be a bad idea sometimes, I should say. Sometimes if you speed up too much, you know, things will just progress faster and you'll be the slower paced of the businesses. You know, if you're not doing anything, you can go bankrupt really quick if you got it on the fast speed. Oh, it looks like it automatically went back to normal. Okay, whatever. Where was it? It's okay. Trains can go this long. That's sort of the good thing about trains in this game. They're pretty versatile. Oh yeah, and the longer the line... Like, the longer the distance that the cargo goes, the more money you make. That's something that I didn't learn until I was, like, an adult playing this game. And I've played this game... This game has been a part of my life through most of... Pretty much since I was a kid and I first played it. I don't know what it is about this game. I just keep on coming back to it. I just like the vibe of this game. I love the soundtrack. I wish that it would play more than just this one. But I just really like this game a lot. If you like Transport Tycoon, you'll probably like this. If you played it before, I guess stick to Transport Tycoon. Just stick to what you know. I've never played Transport Tycoon, the original one, myself, but I've played this game a lot, so I tend to go for this game. But really, they're the exact same. So yeah, what I'm doing now is I'm making another train line to bring paper to this place. And what I'm gonna do is that since this is such a long distance, I am going to make two trains going through this. Yeah, I bet you didn't see that coming, did you? You can have it's actually a better strategy to make all of your trains double tracked. You can really do it either way, but this is how you get more money. Down. Wow. Okay, I'm actually gonna. Okay, I'm just gonna shuffle through the whole mix. Just because I don't feel like I'm gonna be playing this for like the whole of it. So, yeah, as I mentioned earlier, this game, it goes on like not real time, but it has its own like timer to it. Time passes pretty fast in this game, so you can start a game and like 1900 and go all the way potentially to like 2100, you know, you can go into the future. Oh, this is gonna be difficult. I might just make a tunnel. That'd be cheaper than... not really. Okay. I'll just go with the bridge then. How am I doing? Ooh, nobody's really tailing me too bad. This is interesting. I should have made the... Well, I put the player... the other company difficulties to random. So I assume that there would be a couple of them that really, you know... haul it, you know? But... I guess not. What was I saying earlier? I don't remember. I swear I have ADD. Maybe I should check the requirements for the assignment. One of the things mentioned on the assignment is that I got to talk about the cultural like context for this, and there's really not a whole lot to discuss. It's a game made by white people about capitalism. You know, that's pretty much it in a nutshell. There's like you know the drill. I guess it is like pretty European in a way, but notice I'm using American dollars, USD, if you will. And there are maps in this game that are replicas of real life places. Oh, you're taking my business. Oh, you slippery son of a gun. What is the point of this? What is the purpose? Why did you make a loop-de-loop here? You could have just whatever. Okay, but yeah. Now the computer players are starting to do their thing. Oh yeah. And see, this is a complete other thing here. Some of the AI will go nuts with how far their train lines go. Sometimes they'll go completely across the map, and they pretty much, in computers. The AI pretty much always goes for this double track setup as well. So it gets really annoying when they take up a bunch of space. But anyway, that looks good there. I'm actually, instead of taking out any more loans, I'm just going to wait a bit because my monthly profit is... Oh, you... Okay. Yeah, but see, I'm making good money, so... all right. Well, I guess it's time to strike, then. Gotta strike while the iron's hot, as they say. So I'm basically gonna make two trains like this. And this is where it gets kinda tricky. In this case, it's not always better to wait for a full load of whatever you're transporting. I'm gonna do it for this train. But eventually there's going to be two trains waiting in tandem, and if a train is waiting for this one too long, it's just going to turn around and go back to the other station. That's just what happens. So, yeah, I'm going to route through waypoint. We're going over. I'm going to route through this waypoint as well. And I'm, no matter what, I'm going to unload all paper. So, I'm just going to put it on wait for full load of paper to start with, because... if you'll check this station, the production of paper is not very good. Let me check chat while I'm waiting here. Hello, Logan Lindner. You're still here. I'm happy that you're here. Oh, okay, looks like, I probably should have said your full name, whatever. Your full name is in the chat, it's fine. Okay, so notice now that paper is doing pretty good in production because I've finally got a train that's picking it up. So I am going to quickly make a new train. And it's going to go on the same route as this train. Yep. A little paper. No. Okay, yeah, I'm going to make sure that it's, are they on the same thing? Nope, they're different. Okay. The train AI can be really stupid in this game, and that they'll just sort of get on the same track, and then they'll, you know, they won't run into each other, they won't crash, but they'll just stop, and then one of them will turn around, and then business is halted, and then, you know, the market crashes, and then I'm bankrupt, and now I'm business. No, I'm just kidding. But it's just it's a pain in the neck. So, I turned off that it's not going to pick up full loads anymore, just because I got to keep a rhythm going with this one. Okay, looks like they're being pretty smart, so I am... Oh, what? Oh, I made this really confusing. Okay. I'm going to... It's not, since it's not using anything, I'm actually just going to pick it up and put it right here. Or since it's not carrying anything right now. Yeah, I'm just going to put that train right here. This is actually better if it's like right behind this train. They'll have less, they probably won't run into each other too much. That's my thought anyhow. So cool. And it looks like I'm doing pretty good. So, okay, I'm back on top. I'm making $17,000 a month from my vehicles, and I've got a company value of $700,000. That's cool. Ah. But yeah. So, what am I going to do? think, okay, I'm going to look at the towns real quick, sort by population. We don't have very many big cities yet. In fact, we have none at all. This is the biggest town right here. Soggyton. This is the biggest town on the island. And that needs to change. Because what happened here is this paper mill, this printing works, it's now that it's getting paper, it's making goods, specifically. And those goods can only really be transported to cities. And the cities need to have big buildings. So, okay, so each of these little buildings has like a certain thing to it. Okay, perfect. So this, these kind of apartments here, they take goods. Every single one of these buildings accepts passengers, so if I put a passenger stop on any of these, there would be, goods. Let's go with, sausage gates. I'm gonna do a fun little thing here. I'm gonna make a network between all the towns. I'm gonna make a bus network between all three of the towns. And we're gonna make, and the one thing I mentioned that the passengers don't generate a whole lot of money. But what they are good for is that the more passengers that I take to these towns and cities, the bigger they get. Because I guess it just gains way for more buildings to grow, more houses. I guess they're assuming that people are moving between these places. Doesn't make a whole lot of sense in real life, but in this game it makes perfect sense. But anyway, so I'm just gonna... I notice I made a little highway between these three towns. I'm gonna put that there. Ferryton Mines now accepts the passengers. Fantastic. I don't need that. Take a soup sipping break. Hold on. Sorry. Okay. I just got a new microphone. Not just for the purposes of this stream, although I was very excited for this stream, I will say. I've been kind of looking forward to this all week, and I intentionally did it early. This midterm live stream isn't even... I didn't even have to do it until Sunday, but, you know, I got a busy work schedule, and I have a free evening tonight for once, so I figured that this would be the perfect time. And I'm gonna make a bunch of buses. Let's get this place bussing. And then just to mix things up a bit, I'm gonna make some buses that go the opposite direction. How about that? If I go too crazy, I'm just going to be dumping money into a business that doesn't really make a lot of money. But yeah, okay. So the bigger that these towns grow, the more passengers I'll be able to transport. See, here's the thing about buses. The reason that they're probably not making a lot of money is that not a lot of passengers come from these tiny little towns. But again, that's going to be a steady decrease. In fact, let me check how much the buses... Oh, this one's making -7. These ones are all new, so it doesn't matter. Oh my god, is he stuck? Oh, something's gone wrong. Oh, this bus broke down. Okay, cool. So there's nothing really... One passenger transported 14 blocks in 7 days. Well, anyway. So yeah, they're kind of a slow burn. But trust me, they are useful. That bus just drove through that bus. Yeah. But what I can do right now, actually, is I can get some trucks going from here to here. And I'm going to make a cargo loading bay here. And I guess I'll just make some road over here. Yep, good. Okay, that won't accept anything. Never mind. Well, at least I have that cargo loading bay later. It's still going to produce goods as long as there's a factory there. Or paper, whatever it's called. Printing works. As long as there's a printing's works here, they'll be generating goods. Even if nobody's picking them up. So we're good. It's still 1943, and this game does a cool little thing where it chooses its music playlist based on the time of it. Like the era that it's that I'm in. So that's cool. Oh snap! Okay, they're not picking up a whole lot of. Yeah, this one's making it negative. Oh, okay, that's pretty. I'm gonna keep an eye on that. Be careful. But I mean, otherwise I'm doing pretty good. Again, I'm still on top. Has my, like... No, it's still looking the same. Alright. So, let's see. What can I do next? This is hard! No, yeah, this... I can definitely see why people say Twitch, like... Or just live streaming video games is hard. This is a no-brainer. Do I want to do trucks? Yeah, let's truck it. Okay, so here hold on. Yeah, I could do a boat, thing here. And you know, I probably should, just so I demonstrate it. There's a weird glitch in this game, with the boats, where if the path that they gotta go on is complicated enough, they'll just eventually glitch out and start going in circles. But this is a pretty straight shot here, so I think we're good. And I'm just gonna wait for full load of coal. Now, the boats are really slow. But they can carry a lot. And, you know, you don't have to buy... They're not that expensive compared to, like... Like, they're about as expensive as a train. Just by themselves. So... And they can carry a lot. So if I can get multiple of these guys going... then I can have a pretty good business going here. Let's see, is it making... Yeah, look, it's 100 tons of coal. Just to compare. Just compare here. One of these wagons can carry 25 tons of coal. Meanwhile, this thing can carry 150 tons of coal, or food, or goods, or grain, or iron ore, or livestock, or lumber, or mail, or paper, or steel. These things are pretty versatile, except for the steam ferry, which only carries passengers. But these cargo ships can carry so many different things. So, assuming that it doesn't glitch out, we should be good to go. I don't think it will. Yeah. Wait for a full load of coal, why not? Although that looks like they're gonna be another ship for a while. Oh no, he's good to go. Oh, he's bussing. Look at him go. Oh, yeah. Oh, this is gonna be a good moneymaker. Oh, I forgot I'm on camera. I can't be scratching my chest. This is hard! I don't know. How do you Twitch streamers do it? How do you sit in front of a camera talking to people for so long, how can you still be funny doing that?
I don't know.
But hey,
my hat's off to you. I'd actually take my hat off, but it's... I have a bad head.
Yeah, I don't expect too many people to check it out. I made a post on Snapchat saying that I'm going to be doing this, but only on Snapchat. And I told a few friends that they can show up if they want to, but I'm not being graded on my audience, so that's fine. And people can watch this later if they want to, and they can have my nice... my nice voice as background noise. Let's see, what can I do? I like this song. It feels very SimCity. I could have played SimCity 4. That would have been fun. Nah, but I know more about this game, and I'm better at it. I'm really bad at SimCity for some reason. Oh, okay, so this person. Wait, okay, what is the point? What is the point? Oh, you know, it's kind of... I see. Yeah, okay, that makes sense. You know what I could do? I'm a genius. I make a... Okay, I don't care. I don't care if the mines accept passengers. Wait for full load of grain. Move that up. You know, you actually don't really have to set it to unload all of X cargo. Because it generally just does that by default. So it doesn't really matter. Cool. Alright, no, I'm fast forwarding it. I got promoted to traffic manager. That's, level tier 3, if you will. Okay, I just want to make sure that this ship doesn't, like, glitch out just from trying to haul one simple route. Doesn't look like it. Doesn't look like it. No? Okay, we're good. Alright, well then as soon as it leaves, I'm going to put another ship in. Because I like the boats when they actually work it. Oh, whoops. That's a mistake you don't want to make. Notice how this cost 37,000, but when I sold it, it made 32,000. Yeah, we don't want that. I guess I should show off all of the different... I've already shown off trains, buses, trucks, and ships. Let's, okay, this is a pretty big town. Let's make a tram station, or a tram system. So, yeah, we got trams in this game. They're pretty much just, like, buses, but slightly better. And basically what you do is you make the tram track right on the roads. You can build them off, but, you know, there's no real point in that. It's pretty much, it's a streetcar, you know? It's like a bus, but it's faster and more efficient, and it can carry more people. But same deal, you just make a tram track. It has, like, the overhead, wires by default. And then you make passenger stations. Yeah. Build trams. Yeah, see, look how fast he's going compared to, like, the buses. I guess they don't abide by the speed limit or whatever because they're trams. There's no cars in this game. I wonder if trams are... I actually don't know if they make more money than buses. How am I buses doing money-wise? I got 10. Yeah, might have been a bit overkill. Or are those cities at least getting bigger? Sorry, hold on. Not really. Weird. Well, I mean, it takes them a long time. But, yeah, so none of these are going to accept goods, are they? It says... Oh, okay, so how it works is if four of these apartments are present, then it accepts food. If eight of them are present, then it accepts goods. So you really gotta build the cities up in order to make it work. But I wonder, if I were to make a cargo loading station here... Nothing, okay. You know what's annoying? So, okay, there's... You can haul mail in this game. Mail is one of the cargo that you can haul. Yeah, whatever. But you can, and you, pretty much any building produces mail, but none of them accept it, which makes no sense to me. Everybody, like, what are they? They expecting it to be a post office? Like, there's no post office in this game. Why do these houses not accept mail? I guess it's because, you know, you're supposed to make money off of it, and you know the homeowners or the citizens don't, we don't usually pay for a mail to get delivered to us, it just comes. Unless it's a bill. Heyo! Anyway, I gotta find something else to build. Ooh, this is one of my favorites. I friggin' love this song. I'm gonna be quiet for just a second. So y'all can listen to it. Pretty low on convenient things to trade and transport. Oh, see, here we go. I don't know if it's just because... Okay, so this is what happens. I think it's just because the boat is waiting for this other boat to go, so I'm gonna get rid of the wait for full load. See what happens then. Yeah, it was just doing that because it's waiting. But these ships, like, sometimes if it's on a complicated path, it just does that for no reason, which is annoying. I've seen it happen so many times, and it's so frustrating. Anyway. They aren't carrying any goods, are they? No. Okay. Anyway, I was gonna make a rail line from this oil rig to this oil refinery. I really hope that the audio quality... I know the audio quality is good. I just bought this microphone today. It's a Blue Yeti. I didn't buy it just for this class. I've been needing a proper microphone for a while. This just happened to be... I went to Best Buy today, and the guy said that this was the best one, except he didn't really seem like he cared. Like, he was... I approached him. I probably could have made the decision on my own, but he was just standing there in the Windows section looking really bored. I just told him, hey, man, do you mind helping me decide on a microphone? And he's just like, yeah, just buy a Blue Yeti. All the other ones suck. Buy a Blue Yeti. So, I don't know. I mean, it's good. I know Blue Yeti microphones are good. This is not... Why am I talking about Blue Yeti microphones? This is a... I'm supposed to be talking about the culture, the historical significance of this game. Yeah, you know, that's something I thought about, you know, right before this stream started, and I didn't give it much thought before then, but I think I was supposed to pick a game that had, like, real, like, cultural significance or some sort of just like you know, it depicts something, social problem, cultural thing. But I mean, I just like this game a lot, and I can talk about it a lot. And honestly, at a certain point, it gets to a point where the land is just so full of stuff. See, look at this. This was all like open nature and stuff, but just because of the way that the game is set up and how big the grids are, everything is filled up with good stuff. Oh, hey! Oh, I did it! Oh, perfect. Okay, I successfully completed my challenge. So technically, I just won the game. Technically. Wow. I can keep playing as long as I want. But I achieved a company value of $2 million, which is the goal of the scenario that I put at the very beginning. And I am hauling it. So I'm going to keep going for a little while longer. And then I'm just going to, show off a couple more things. Show off the point that I was talking about just a second ago. And then I'll probably call it good. We've passed the hour mark. It's 8:06. I hope that anybody who's watching this is having a good evening. This is hard, and I'm not sure if I'll ever do Twitch streaming again, but I'm really enjoying myself. I should have made it like a bigger city somewhere, because this is going to take forever. But I think I'm just going to... You know what? I'm doing really good. So I think I'm just going to keep it on, the really fast. I have enough money. I can pay back all of my loans here. Boom. I have zero loans, zero debt. I am rolling in the dough. How are those... Are those buses making money? Not really. But my trains are really good. My trucks are good. All this stuff is good. Oh, the ships are real money making. At least these two are. I think I kind of... Alright, I'm going to stop this one. And I'm just going to let it sit for a bit. So that they're not just, butting heads. Alright, that's good. So I think now is the time that I bust out the airplanes. Yeah. Oh, these are the real money makers. I mentioned earlier, airplanes, at a certain point, this whole map is going to be covered in airports and stuff. So, okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to build an airport. We only have the medium one right now. That's fine. There's also a heliport, which we'll probably see later. And you know what? I am going to... That only costs 94. What? Wow. Okay. Oh, it's these damn pylons. Yeah, this works. Okay, so we got a Sausage Gate Airport. And I'll make another one over, here in Gogglewood. Where my headquarters are. Which, by the way, you might have noticed, got a little bit of an upgrade. It's now like one of those industry offices that you'd see in just any old small town. And it upgrades every two stages. If when I reach 30%, it should... when I reach 40%, it will upgrade again. But anyway. Airplanes. So, looks like the best option right now is this one. Edit a scenario and show you some of the newer stuff. I don't think I need to do that. Okay, so yeah, we got this airplane. It can carry 24 passengers and it goes 150 miles per hour. And it's gonna make, it's just gonna make flights from Quack Bottom to Gogglewood. Where is that other place? Where is it? Oh, I put an extra Quack Bottom. I didn't mean to do that. But that's, I mean, they're one and the same. They're like St. Paul and Minneapolis. They're twin cities. And then the other one that I was looking at was over here. Okay. So, I am just gonna, okay, we got 12 passengers. That's good. Just gonna enlarge this and just watch as it goes.
Flight number one. Departing from Quack Bottom Airport. Taking off right now.
Oh, I'm such a nerd. Wow, it's real. Some of the airplanes in this game go really fast. Like, you'll, later on in the game, you'll get like a Boeing 747. They'll have one of those like jet planes, like that, and they'll go like 700 miles per hour. Like there's like a, oh, I don't remember what it's called, but there's a like a jet, like practically a rocket ship, basically. That goes like 500 miles per hour. Oh, okay, the plane's here. Here we are. So, yep, it's gonna fly around a bit. Going all around. It looked like it was going down for a second, but it's not. And now it's landed. Boom. New airspeed record. Speed of 142 miles per hour between stops. It's probably not gonna make me too much money. I didn't see how much that was. I shouldn't have sped it up. But I'm gonna make another plane. You can only really make airplanes when you really become successful, because they're expensive. They're pretty expensive, especially later on. They're the most expensive vehicle. And airports are pretty expensive as well. This town, Swindle over here is getting pretty big. I'm gonna capitalize off of that. That's really the only, Yeah, see there? Okay. Perfect example of what I was about to say. This game is, like, capitalist, like, gold. In that everything, you can literally do most things that really just aren't morally right. Like, I just destroyed an entire block of houses to make this airport for my, and mind you, it's not even necessarily a city's airport. Other companies, other airlines, quote-unquote, but actually traveling companies, cannot use these airports. Only I can. So this is a corporate airport that I just bought on somebody's property, and they lost their house because of it. You can just do stuff like that in this game. And once you get to a certain point, there's, like, everybody's, like, messed up the land so much with railways and roads and airports and industries that it really just doesn't matter. In fact, speaking of which, $1 million. Okay, so the pinnacle of money spending in this game are the industries. So if at a certain point, if I save up enough money, if I wanted to just build a factory right next to like a chemical plant, I could do that. But that's gonna cost a lot of money, and I think I just need to save up for a bit. Oh, I got ranked down. I'm still on top, but I'm an engineer now. Probably because I spent all that money. Alright, looks like the stream is still going. Alright, that's good. I hope that, I mean, I sure hope that it didn't mess up. I guess I should fix my hair. Oh, that farm just closed down. Oh, I didn't even notice. Okay, that doesn't affect me. So yeah, industries can close down in this game. And it can be completely random. It's pretty much at random. So I can have a perfectly good train line set up. Like say I'm doing fine over here. Like I'm making money off of this, and then one day this paper mill just randomly closes down. That can happen. It's kind of nuts, and then you have to delete the whole thing. Yeah, it looks like that that paper trick worked. Wow! Oh, there's a new wheat farm over by Soggy Town. Where's that? I was just there. Is there a food processing plant nearby? Oh, we'll get there. We'll get there when we get there. If I buy any more airports, it's gonna cost me a lot of money, so I'm gonna back off on that for now. But I'm still making pretty good money, so I gotta make some plays here. I'm probably just gonna play for a little while longer. Do I wanna do the dirty? No, that's too far away. I don't feel like making the railroad that long. And that's another painful thing is that I gotta. If I wanted to make this, I'd have to put it against a mountain, which is annoying. Yeah, not worth it. Do I have any cargo bearing airplanes? No, I don't. Oh, these planes are right behind each other. How many passengers is this carrying? Only 5? Oh, and it broke down as soon as it landed. Oh, that's funny. One thing that can help with that is I can put a passenger stop right here. And if I get a bus to like go back and forth from between like these two stops even, that'll make more passenger generation here. Oh, you're at max capacity, buddy. Oh, you're just waiting for this plane to get in. Makes sense. Okay. Before I wrap things up here. Oh, what? If we not accept food. Interesting. Is there a food processing plant anywhere nearby? Yeah, no. So, I might just buy something off that. Okay, so before I, like, do my, like, finishing thoughts and, like, wrap up things around here, I'm just gonna double check if there's anything else that I needed to talk about for this assignment. Because my voice is getting tired. Probably shouldn't have had a Red Bull this late. I didn't drink as much of it as I thought I would. I cracked one open just to have more energy for this. And I think it worked, but, you know. Gonna be up all night. We're up all night to get lucky. Oh, yeah. See, okay, so notice, See, this town is developing around the roads that we made, that me and this other company made. Also, this is so annoying. Oh my god, I hate this. Why would you do this? We got a train intersection here, and we got 2 other intersections. This is halting so much productivity for literally everyone. And that's why it's important to set the routes, because if you just let a truck loose, it's not going to know where to go. And it might end up driving on someone else's turf, you know? Posture check. Let me see if there's anything else. So this is, yeah, it's playing ragtime music now. This is what we'd be playing if I started the game in, like, 1900.
Which is a drag, because back then there's not a lot of money being made, and the vehicles are really slow. Okay. So, I guess, yeah, as I mentioned, this is a pretty European game, actually. A lot of the maps take place in Great Britain and stuff. In fact, I'm going to save real quick. Okay, I don't have any real things made. I'm going to save this real quick. Frog's weed, yeah, man! Oh, those frogs are having fun. Look, oh my god, look at all these trucks. That is a lot of trucks. See, you can go crazy with the trucks if you want to. Okay, yeah, these towns are starting to get a little bigger. I think especially with the airport now. Sausage Gate is gonna get huge. I'm really funny. I'm literally 12. Can any of these places accept goods now? Question mark? Food. Okay, nothing there. Hello, aeroplane. You know, I'm gonna fast forward it for a little while. Yeah, it gets even crazier than this even later on in the game. I think that's one of the biggest takeaways from this game for me. If I were to apply any sort of cultural or societal rhetoric to this game, it's just how bad, like, capitalism is sort of consuming land. Or at least it can if it's not controlled. Or not even capitalism, just the pursuit of money, which I guess in turn is capitalism. Like, greed, like, towards, like, you know, big scale things like this. It can really mess up the land. There's other, like I said, there's maps of Great Britain and, like, America, and I've played games on there where, at a certain point, Great Britain just becomes covered, caked in railroad tracks, and, we got a pretty big city here. Oh, they had a passenger train. Of course, how could I oh, I should have done that. Ooh, okay. So, let me see if I can make, like, a mail system. Are these the biggest towns right now? Yeah, they are. Oh man, I've been so foolish. I should have made the passenger trains. Oh yeah, I can check other companies. Okay, not. See, that's the thing. This game keeps track of so much different stuff. It's actually kind of nuts. I can check how other companies are doing. Okay, so we got a station that accepts mail, so I'm gonna put that there. And, can I put anywhere else? Please. Oh, come on, this is the biggest town. Oh, I did put the tram station here, so that might have been a thing or two. Alright, well, that's fine. They don't have to all make mail. They just gotta, or they don't have to all accept it.
I said a lot while ago that I was going to wrap up soon, and that, yet I still have it. Did I pick a mail truck for sale? It doesn't look like a mail truck to me, but that's because it's 1940-something. So this is the one that accepts... Yeah. Okay. And, yep, the city's just gonna keep on growing through time. Oh, I can make an industry. I'm going to do so. Just to show that process. Or no. Okay, so I'm gonna make a factory nearby this chemical plant. Because factories require chemicals to... Oh, not enough cash. Oh, that's gonna tank my entire account. Never mind. Who am I kidding? I'm about to end the stream anyhow. Give me your money, so I can spend it recklessly. Wow! New factory under construction near Hippoville. Nice. All right. And yeah, once that's up and running, I can. I'm making $50,000 a month. Dude, this has been a pretty good game, all things considered. I'm quite happy with how it turned out. I was hoping for a little bit more suspense, conflict, action. But, what can you get? I made it easy intentionally so I could really demo the game. If I was being smart, though, I would have made it like a bigger city, so you could see how that worked. And then I might have put it in like the 2000s and like made the other companies more aggressive so that they would... eventually make more lines just to illustrate the point about capitalism I was trying to make. But it's not going to work out that way, I think. Let's just build one more train and call it good. Oh, you sneaky. Oh, so sneaky. Oh, I see what you're doing. And you're gonna destroy this poor house! You're gonna destroy this house! So that... Just for your own gain. Do you have... Have you no shame? No mercy? We don't need two of those. Turn around. Every time now, except... Okay, what is the deal with you? You're so flip-floppy, I just need you for the coal. You don't need to accept anything. I accept you the way you are. Alright, victory lap, let's go! And now that's making money for me. Yeah, nice. I should have put my headquarters here. Okay, well, that's pretty much Chris Sawyer's Locomotion. It's a spiritual successor to Transport Tycoon, made by one guy, published by Atari, made in 2004, even though it really looks like it's from the 90s, and it's just a fun game. If you like simulation games and this all sounds good, I would highly recommend it. Even though it's an old game, it's still available on Steam. For a pretty low price, like less than $10 if I recall correctly. It's a fun game. It sort of teaches you a thing or two about businesses and how they run, and like sort of puts that in your mind. It shows the evils of capitalism in a very subtle way that I don't think even the programmer intended. I don't think he intended this to have any sort of deep social rhetoric, but I'm just sort of pulling it because it's what I think of anyhow. When it gets to that point. And, yeah. Yeah, so I'm just gonna save this game. Replace that. And I'm gonna exit. I'm just gonna show a couple more things. Yeah, so here's the, that Great Britain map. it's a nice little recreation of Britain, but it, you know, everything's much bigger. This is what London looks like, blah blah blah. This one is in 1955, and they use pounds instead of dollars. They also have America. They have North America East, the East Coast, they got the Midwest, and then they got the West not even the West Coast, it's just West. And it's conveniently cuts off right at before where Oregon would be. So like you got San Francisco, Reno, and then it just cuts off. That always really disappointed me as a kid that Oregon wasn't big. That it didn't go for the full West Coast vibe. It just went for Southwest. Oh my god, look at how big these buildings are. I should have been playing on this map. Or these towns, I mean. Look at this. Oh my god, I would have had so much to work with. So much flat space and road and stuff. Look at how overly developed this is, though. It's just all houses and churches, no big buildings. And that's, you're supposed to kind of fill in the gaps, I guess. But this game mode is starting off in 1980. It's Albuquerque. Alright, well, that's gonna do it for me. Once again, my name is Cameron Utz. If you're tuning in during the time, Logan, thank you. In fact, I'm gonna check if anyone else was logged into this one. Or tuned in, I should say. Alright, looks like everyone's gone. Well, anyway, to those of you who checked it out, thank you for tuning in. I'm gonna make sure this gets uploaded to YouTube so people can watch it later, and then if you are an SOU student, or if you're my professor who's watching this live stream, I hope you enjoyed it for, you know, what it is, even if you didn't pay attention to all of it. I get it, it's kind of not a lot of people know this game, that can appear boring on the surface, but I really wanted to play it for this assignment. I really enjoy this game. There's a lot that I can say about it. It's very nuanced. It's very well-programmed. I like the graphics. I like the low-key lettering. Look at this nice... Okay, so, yeah, at a certain point, you can get airboards that are this nice. I really should have picked it later. So be it, you know. Anyway, that will do it for me. Thank you all for tuning in, and if I do this again, I hope to see you there. Later.